They say you never pass O'Connor Bridge without seeing a white horse.
I see a white man this time. Did I ever tell you about Johnny and King Billy's statue?
Who's Johnny?
Well, the late lamented Patrick Morcombe, my grandfather, was, as you know, a glue boiler.
Grand said he had a starchman.
Well, starch or glue. Anyway, he had a horse called Johnny, and Johnny used to work in the mill, walking round and round it in order to drive the mill. And one fine day, the old gentleman decided that he'd like to drive out with the quality to a military review in the park. So he dressed himself out in his best top hat, his best collar, and off he went. And everything went along beautifully until they came to King Billy's statue. And whether Johnny fell in love with the horse King Billy sits on, or whether he thought he was back again in the mill, he started to walk round and round the statue. The old gentleman, he was highly indignant. He couldn't stop him. He said, "Johnny, Johnny, what's the matter with the animal? I can't understand the beast. Most extraordinary conduct." And he had to get out and walk Johnny home.
Thinking about that song, The Lass of Auchinleck.
What about that song? Why should that make you cry?
I'm thinking about a person long ago who used to sing that song.
Who was that person long ago?
It was a person I used to know in Galway when I was living with my grandmother.
Someone you were in love with?
It was a young boy I used to know named Michael Fury. He used to sing that song, The Lass of Auchinleck. It was very delicate. I can see him so plainly. Such eyes as he had. Big, dark eyes. And an expression.
Oh, so you are in love with him?
I used to go out walking with him when I was in Galway.
And perhaps that was why he wanted to go to Galway with that Ivers woman.
What for?
Well, how do I know? To see him, perhaps.
He's dead. He died when he was only 17. Isn't it a terrible thing to die so young as that?
What was he?
He was in the gas box.
I suppose you were in love with this Michael Fiore letter.
I was great with him at the time.
Was it he died of so young? Consumption.
I think he died for me. It was in the winter. About the beginning of the winter. I was leaving my grandmother's house to come up to the convent in Dublin. He was ill at the time in lodgings in Galway. Wouldn't be let out. And his people in Oughterard were written to. He was in decline, they said, or something like that. I never knew rightly. Poor fellow. He was very fond of me. He was such a gentle boy. We used to go out walking together, you know, Gabriel, the way they do in the country. He was going to study singing only for his health. He had a very good voice. Poor Michael Fury.
Well. And then?
Then, when it came time for me to leave Galway and go up to the convent, he was much worse. And I wouldn't be let to see him. So I wrote him a letter saying I was going up to Dublin, would be back in the summer, and hoping he'd be better by then. Then the night before I left, I was in my grandmother's house in Lens Island packing up. I heard gravel thrown up against the window. The window was so wet I couldn't see out. So I ran downstairs as I was and slipped out the back into the garden. And there was the poor fellow at the end of the garden, shivering.
Did you not tell him to go back?
I implored of him to go home at once. I told him he'd get his death in the rain. He said he did not want to live. I can see his eyes swell as well.
Did he go home?
Yes. He went home. And after I was only a week in the convent, he died. He was buried in Oughterard. His people came. Oh, the day I heard that, he was dead.